This video is brought to you by Storyblocks Audio. What up you guys, it's Janik here for CineCam.net and welcome to another Copycat Friday. In this series we recreate visual effects from famous movies and music videos. And this week we are recreating an effect from the new music video from A$AP Rocky. The kids turned out fine. No, Jordi isn't sick or away. He is right here keeping an eye on me. I think he's afraid that I will break the red camera if he goes away again. But we decided it's time again for me to practice my presentation skills. That's why I'll be your host today and boy, we are going on a journey today. Like, literally. For this effect you need a lot of locations. As you all saw in the beginning of the video, we are going to recreate the endless scene transition effect from A$AP Rocky. You can see in this clip that the different scenes blend in each other with some careful masking. And this is what we are going to show you today, with two different types of camera movements. Now let's start with the first movement and the location. Okay, this will do for our first location. But before we start with the movement, I would first like to thank our sponsor, Storyblocks Audio. This is a library where you can find sound effects and music. And I can say it's a library that I genuinely use myself. Definitely for sound effects. Basically, you pay one single price per year, which allows you to download unlimited sound effects, ambience, music, loops, and so much more. You can click in the first link in the description below for more information. Now it's time to pay attention to your surroundings. What you are going to need are foreground elements. These are necessary for the effect. Otherwise, you don't have anything to mask around in post-production. So go on a hunt for those foreground elements. You don't always have to have one in the beginning and one in the back. The clips are going to overlap, so you can use the foreground element from the previous or the next clip. Just make sure you have at least one foreground element. Then you'll be safe. Now for the camera movement, which is going to be handheld or a gimbal. In A$AP Rocky clip, you can see the camera really moves in the scene, going closer and further to the subjects. And this is what you also want to do. Really move through the scene. But before you can do this, you need to determine the direction for the transition. This can be from the left to the right or whatever side you like. Just remember to maintain the direction throughout the entire effect. You can try to change the direction mid-scene, but I don't recommend it. So now that we know we are moving from the left to the right, you can do your other movements. You don't always need to go in a straight line. Do something creative, but maintain your direction. Also remember to provide some bleed in the beginning of your clip and in the end. Otherwise you can't overlap it with the other shots. But most important, let your foreground element move completely through the screen from one side to the other. Okay, now that we have the movement, I want to say one last thing before we go to the next location. In the A$AP Rocky music video, all the actors stand still. Well, this isn't necessary, but it can give an extra touch to your effect. So you can choose yourself if you want to do that. Now let's go to the other locations and film the rest we need for our effect. Okay, now that we have all our shots, let's jump into Premiere Pro. Load in all your clips in the project and create a montage of the shots. Now your clips are already in the correct order you want. The next thing you need to do now is the masking part. You start with the begin clip and look for the foreground element we can use to mask out. We have one in the end of our begin clip, so place that clip one track higher. Next, look for the point where your foreground element is completely in the shot. Go to the effects control panel and under opacity you can find the pen tool for creating custom masks. Now create a detailed mask around the right side of it. On this side, your next shot will be introduced and visible. Go back to the effects control panel and enable the animation for the mask path. Now you are probably thinking, why didn't you start the mask animation from the point the foreground element comes in? Well, I find this easier because now you know exactly how many masking points you are going to need to mask out the element. The only thing you now have to do is animate the mask while going back in time until the foreground element is off screen on the right side. Now go back to the point where we started the animation earlier on, and now you can animate the mask while going further in time. Try to do this as precise as possible, because any shift or small error will probably be visible due to the underlaying layer. For the next step, it's time to align the underlaying clip. Let this one start at the exact same time as your mask animation starts. If the speed of the two clips don't match, you can also speed ramp one to match the other. For an in-depth tutorial about speed ramping, check out the link in the description below. And that is really all there is to it. Just mask out your foreground element and align everything to get the smooth transitions. the A$AP Rocky music video, they also added these glowing scribble effects. Well, we couldn't explain it, but we already did that in an After Effects tutorial completely dedicated to this effect and Kendrick Lamar. So if you want to learn about that, go in the description below to find a link about that.
So as you can see, the effect is super simple to recreate without having much equipment. Now, if you do like to take it to that next level, you can work with motion-controlled equipment. This right here is a slider from Syrup, which is a well-known brand in the industry for having these motion-controlled stuff. And we're actually looking here at three types of products. We've got the slider that you can purchase separately, but you can also purchase the tracking hat right here, and on top of that, also the pan and tilt hat. You can also purchase the pan and tilt hat separately if you like so, and that way you can kind of mount it to a tripod and only do pan and tilt movements. Now these things right here connect to your phone, which allows you to program any kind of movement like Jennik is doing right now on this slider. And that is pretty cool because this means that we can shoot something right here and take all of this stuff with us to a second location and do the exact same movements again. And that is going to be really interesting as the two shots will perfectly match together, and we're going to see later in this video also how we can use this to our benefit. Now the Syrup slider is obviously very cool, but if you don't have such a slider, you can also use a gimbal. Obviously this doesn't allow you to slide, but you can of course pan and tilt at one exact movement. You can use a joystick of your gimbal to do that movement, but you can also use the app. Many gimbals these days comes with an app which allows you to control like that too. And we currently have this gimbal mounted to a tripod, which allows us to set it up everywhere that we want to. Now, like before, take your shot motion controlled with the gimbal as it's doing this pan movement, then just take it up, move to a different location, and make that exact same shot again, also giving you a very smooth transition between the two.
Now you can do exactly the same thing as with your handheld movements. Shoot your subjects, use foreground elements, but this time let your camera rotate on a tripod, doing the same arc movement at the same speed over and over again. This will ensure perfect smooth transitions. Now in post-production, it's also exactly the same as with the first effect. But now that the transition from one scene to the other is so smooth, we can do something special. First, you want to make a shot where a large portion of the end of the clip is just a wall or an even surface. Then you want to make a shot where you open a door. Make sure that the door is situated on the left of the room and opens from the left to the right, so that it flows with the transitions. Now in Premiere Pro, place the shot with the wall in the end on track number 1, and the shot with the door on track number 2. Let the door shot start whenever you seem fit. Select the door shot and go to the effects control panel and take the pen tool. Now create a mask in the door opening so that the only thing you see is within the door frame. Again, go to the effects control panel and enable the animation for the mask pad. Go back in time and animate the mask till the door closes and nothing is visible anymore from that clip. Then go back further in time and animate the mask opening together with the door. Now when the door is completely open, you can let the right side of the mask go off screen on the right. Just keep animating the left side so that it follows the door frame off the screen on the left. When you have done this all correctly, you'll get this very cool effect. That was it for today, guys. Thank you so much for watching. I hope I explained everything clear enough. Thank you, Storyblocks, for the support. And like always, stay creative. Naar achter ook! Always need to go from the, in a straight line. Well, because any shift or small error. And of the end of the clip is just. Alleen just a wall. Dat is niet zo moeilijk. That was it. And look for the foreground. Alleen.